गुड इवनिंग अमरीन,
वेरी गुड इवनिंग सर। आई
हाउ आर यू?
एम गुड, हाउ आर यू? थैंक
आई एम
यू।
गुड अमरीन, एंड वेलकम टू माय शो।
थैंक यू सर फॉर हैविंग मी हियर। हाँ
नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम, नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम। एंड सो पीपल, दैट्स आवर गेस्ट फॉर टुनाइट, अमरीन बानो। And like I said, Amreen is a ATO and she has the honor to be the first woman ATO in India. And
Thank you.
Amreen, just introduce yourself to the viewers first. How did you and when and how did you join Merchant Navy?
Hi, good evening, everyone. Hello, myself Amreen Bano. I am from Meerut city in Uttar Pradesh. I started my career with Shipping Corporation of India. I did my BE and ETO course from MIT University, Chennai. And before joining the Shipping Corporation of India, I worked with the Meru workshop at Dockyard Road in Mumbai, where I used to visit various ship for various repair work in dry dock. And in workshop also I
This
had like
was
very beginning
after you
before joining
completed
the
your
ship.
training? No, but after
Yes,
your training, after
yes
MET?
sir. Yes, after Amit, as I was searching for the job and I was not getting a job as
So
an ATO on board.
how long were you waiting before you got the ship?
Before I got the ship, it was around a year, 7 to 8 months. I was like roaming in each and every company offices and was applying online as well, but nobody was accepting as a female ETO. They were saying like, are you mad? Who suggested you to join Merchant Navy as an ETO? Like if you would have joined as a deck carrier or something else, like they will take, but ETO they were not taking because as
So,
only a.
which year was that?
It was in 2015, sir. Yeah, no,
2015.
2014, sir. 14, 14.
14. So that
I'm sorry.
time,
Yes, sir.
not too many women sailors were sailing, right?
Yes, that's right, sir, that's right. So
So
then
okay,
I thought like
then you
I got an
went for
opportunity
training.
to, yes. So I was searching, so people were like, they were directly saying no to join, like not accepting me as an ETO on board. Then I got an opportunity to join Samudra Institute as a teacher. But I want to join a ship. I was like determined to join ship only. So then I found a workshop, Meru workshop, because teaching will give only me the theoretical knowledge, which I have already, which I got from my college and everything. I need practical experience to prove myself to enter into the industry. So I found it, and the workshop also they were not accepting because they had never any female, and they're saying they have to go on board for the repair, all the crew. Then I tested them and then they gave me an opportunity, and there I learned a lot about like dry dock and like so many things in their workshop, balancing, then ACB complete, overhauling, many things like we don't get to see those things on board, so it was good. Then after that, SCI published on their website about the interview. Then SCI was my last hope because it is a government company, and like if they don't accept me, then there was no hope. Then I prepared for SCI interview and I gave. Then finally, yes.
Your signal is broken. Can you start again? The SCI published what?
SCI on their website about the interview for ETOs. They are going to take ETOs, so I applied for that and I went there for the interview. And that day, like there was like around 200 ETOs were there for the interview. All were male. I was the only female there. And yes, I gave. They asked many questions, all practical and like all these things. But still, like I was scared. Like as everybody is saying me no, so if whether they will take me or not. Then after everything, all went well. Interview. I was waiting there till evening, and then I asked them like, sir, as SCI will take. So then finally they said we will see that, and then by then the result came. I was working in the workshop only. I was continuing with my experience, practical experience, And then one fine day, I was in dry dock in a cement room, one ship that was OSV, offshore vessel. Then suddenly I got a call from SCI. They are calling me, and it was like I was in a boiler suit there, and tear came out from my eyes. And I just ran from the dry dock in a local train. I was staying in a chawl that too near Curry Road. I researched like where I should stay. So Curry Road is near to Dockyard Road,
I
and
know,
I ran
yeah.
in the boiler suit, and I forgot about my ID and all, like ticket also to carry. And then I was caught in between, and then I convinced them like how I'm running and how I have to reach to the office, SCI office, to report there. And then after that everything went so smooth and well.
So between your interview and your call, how many days wait?
It was around a month, sir.
It was around a month. So
20 to
okay,
30 days wait.
so you go for the interview. There are
And there I had to
some
choose one thing.
how many men were there?
For the interview, sir? Yes. Like ETOs were there for the interviews, around like more than 200. And
Okay.
like interviewer was five, six was there. They were sitting and
Okay.
they asked the questions. Yeah. They
So
went to
you went one by one, or they took three, four, five together?
one by one.
One by one.
Like
And
four
you
people were
and
taking for one.
okay,
Four
so
people were taking for one.
your turn came after how many men went inside already?
I think around 40, 50, it was like
Okay,
that.
okay,
Yeah.
okay. So it
Yes.
was the entire interview was done in one day for everyone?
No, it was not in one
Okay.
day. It took
Okay.
many days, two,
Okay.
three days continuous.
So when you enter, tell me the scene right from you open the door, you knock the door, you enter inside, you see four people, and then tell me.
Yeah, four people. And then like as I already like I was well prepared about this interview. Then they saw the girl and they asked like whether she has all the documents, CDC and all, everything, you know. They were so I was ready with everything, you know, all the documents. Then they started asking me all the technical questions, first about myself and then how to do the mega test and all these things. Will you able to climb on the mast and all this? Then more about something motor, all these things. And I replied to them smoothly because it is professional. During the time of interview, we have to be to the question. So I could not, like, I gave the interview and like with the hope I came out because I replied to all the questions whatever they have asked. So I was with the
So
positive hope.
how long did it take for your interview? Half an hour, 20 minutes?
Yeah, around half an hour, sir. They asked many questions about each and every topic, electrical and electronics. Like, although, sir, I
Did
was
they
a topper
ask
of
you
my
did
batch.
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah,
In
yeah.
my triple E, yeah, I was like gold medalist and topper of my batch in ETO, but still I was not getting job anywhere as an ETO. Nobody was accepting me. It was really, really difficult. I used to
And
walk around.
how was the behavior of these four examiners?
Their behavior was normal. Normal. Not
Normal.
like others, like, yeah, you have choose all these things, you know, wrong. So they were four, so it was normal.
Did they ask you any personal questions?
No, they did not ask there. They just
I mean,
asked personal question like, will you be able to climb the mast? Really, you will be able to work? Yeah, everybody has that doubt. Will you able to work there as an electrical officer? Electricity is, it is nobody friend and it is risky. So nobody want to take a risk to give opportunity to a female. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, all right. So now we go back to your childhood. Tell me
Yes, sir.
something about, how was your childhood? How many people in the house, brother, sister? And at that time, when you were a small kid, did you dream to, do something in life, or it was late reaction?
Yes, sir. We are in my family. We are total five siblings. I have an elder
Okay.
brother. I am the second one. And my
Okay.
younger sister, she's a national player, hockey player.
Oh,
And the
really?
younger, yeah. And she have attended many India camp also. She studied in Delhi University. Then another six, second.
Okay.
Hello. Yes, sir, connection was
Yeah,
broken.
go on. Yeah.
Yes, then another second sister, she is in a archery, she is state level player.
Okay.
Right now
All right.
she's doing cardio perfusion from Jaipur
Okay.
NEEM University. And my brother,
Okay.
elder brother, he is sports goods wholesale business. He has his own firm
Okay. Okay.
manufacturing. So my
Okay. So
mom
when
and
you were a
dad,
small kid, yeah, mom and dad.
like for me, my elder brother and second is me. So from my childhood,
Okay.
I was like they brought me up as a son only. Still at
Okay.
home, they call me as a Imran only. Now
Okay.
only I grow my hair. From my childhood, I was like a tomboy only.
Okay.
No,
Okay.
nobody called
Okay.
me as a girl.
Okay.
So they like, let us dream whatever you can. My parents, they never like differentiate you are a girl and like you should be
Right.
like that. You should not join this. You should not do
Okay.
this. Full of
Okay.
freedom.
Okay.
Yes. What?
When did you decide that you want to, join a sea life? And how the
See.
idea, how did the idea come into your mind? Did you talk to
Yes.
someone?
No, nobody was there. Nobody was there. None of my family member, relatives, or friend. Nobody is there in Merchant Navy from my family. So I was in 12th, so that time I was filling up all the forms, IIT and all these things. And it came, MIT form also came for Merchant Navy field. I was like exploring about the field where I can. And I love, sir, like where I can be in close touch, closely with the practical experience. I don't want any office job and something different. So my other
Okay.
all classmates, everybody, they were choosing to be BSc and all these things, normal courses. But I don't want,
Right.
they were pulling me there. But I want something different. And so I
Okay.
fill up this form and I got selected there and gave interview. And then after I pursued about it, and my father
But
was from.
tell me, how did you come to know? I mean, you're from Meerut, right?
Yes.
Coming
Yes,
from
sir.
Meerut, which is miles away from sea, and how did the idea come? I mean, how you came to know that, okay, there is Merchant Navy sea life, I want to apply there.
Sir, in my 12th standard, I love physics and like electricity. And in my childhood, I got lots of shocks from electricity. So I always target the thing from which I scared the most, and electricity was one of them. Then I came to know about the Merchant Navy, and then more I was researching about this field, I was listening towards it, and then I came to know about
Okay.
ETO. Then that day
Okay.
itself, I decided I can become an ETO. And I was very much determined about it. And then I continued it.
Okay. So another very interesting thing which I read about you studied all the way till 12th or whatever in a Hindi
Yes.
medium school, and
Yes.
then you went to Chennai, and your first challenge was to learn English and then to, do the course, which is amazing, commendable. How did you do that?
Exactly, sir. It was very difficult the first day itself to clear the interview in AMIT. They saw my 12th standard certificate and mark sheet, and they saw, okay, she don't have English, and
Right.
they don't want to take me. And then I
Right.
was like roaming around here and there to the registrar office, to the chairman, and all these things. Like I was proving them I can improve, I can talk. Right now
Okay.
I'm talking to you. I'm able to explain. I can explain my views and thoughts. So they say, she
Right.
is a Meerut girl. Meerut people are very strong. And like till I passed out in AMIT, my name is there and everybody recognized me, Meerut girl, chairman and all.
Right.
And yeah,
Right.
I got very good name. I was actually
That's
topper
yeah.
there also. I proved myself in first year also. In first semester, everybody was thinking like, she is from Hindi medium, she doesn't speak much, and people were thinking like she will be getting back. And I was a rank holder in my class. Then everybody was saying, ये छुटकी ने तो कमाल कर डाला, पीछे से निकल के आ गई. So I
Right,
used
right.
to.
That's commendable, commendable.
Thank you,
Very
sir. Thank
good.
you so much.
Yeah. And tell me other things. Were there any other girls also in the academy, or you were the only girl?
In Tripoli, I was the only girl. Then after 2 months,
Okay.
two Angolan girls, they came to join.
Okay, they came. And
Yes.
how what was the behavior of the boys with you? You know, other boys in the academy and the teachers.
Teachers, I will tell you, sir, one funny thing about the teacher.
Yeah.
Till the
Yeah.
second year or third year, they were not knowing there is a girl in Tripoli. You know, one
Okay.
day we have,
Okay.
this I haven't told to
Yeah.
anyone. Yeah,
Yeah.
so in second year, hydraulic class, hydraulic and pneumatic, sir, he came to the class. He was new teacher, and I was a first bencher. I was sitting in a first bench, and I always use surma, kajal in my
Okay.
eyes. Yeah, I will, yeah, I use in the night, so morning also it will remain there. Then sir came and he was pulling and twisting my ear. You are a boy, behind all the boys, they started shouting, "Sir, she's a girl," and there I had to say, "Sir, I'm a girl."
That's amazing. You
It
know, I'm also reading a lot of comments down below, and people are loving your attitude, and you know they are so happy with you that you had hardship and you're smiling and you are commendable job,
Thank
and people
you.
are, you know,
Thank you, everyone.
everyone is. And thank you, Pradeep Gowda, Tranquil Mindfulness, Arun Simba,
You.
Pradeep Gowda, everyone, thank you so much. She's you
Thank you
can
so
make out,
much.
you know, she's a very a girl full of life, very bubbly, and she struggled in her life, and still she doesn't show it that she struggled, and she wanted to prove herself, and she did prove herself. Okay, so
Thank you so
now
much.
you got a passed in the interview, and SCI selected you, so you went running in your boiler suit, and then you go to the office then.
Yes, I went to the office then. The SCI gave in Don Bosco around 20 to 30 days training, so I attended and completed that. With me, other 21 guys were selected, so we all were doing training together. And then among them, I was the one who got ship the first, you know. And I told my mom, they were in Meerut. I called them like, "I have to join." So I didn't meet them from a year. Still they said, "You are going to pursue your dream, so don't look back, join." And I also decided that. Then my mom, she brought my all the luggage all the way, and my brother, they came. And then while I was, I my first joining was from Mumbai, from yeah. So they all came to see of me, and all my batchmate also. I was so lucky. They all came and see of me, and everybody was crying. I was crying. My mom was crying, crying. It was so emotional. I still have that pic. Yeah,
And how long
it
was the
was
contract on the first ship?
8 months and 13 days. And yeah, there also, sir,
But
one.
how much did you sign for 6 months or 8 months or 9 months?
Eight months, sir. Eight
8 months
months.
contract.
Yes.
Okay, now I will also read some more comments. Kasia Sassi, she says, I'm very inspired. You know, Kasia's name is Kashish. She is right now doing
Thank you.
her cadetship from the same college I
Wow.
met in Chennai.
Oh, great.
Yeah, and
Good.
then I think someone who knows you rangs for you. He says, or she says, I don't know whether girl or a boy, says, I remember you had a haircut during EEE. That's why your teacher thought you were a boy.
Yes, I was short hair and after joining ship. After
So
joining ship only I
now
got
let me ask continue, you know, asking you questions.
my
Okay. So now I will ask you questions, and my first thing is, you know, you joined the ship, and
Yes, sir.
did the people, I mean, I'm sure the, you know, staff on board knew there's a woman ETO coming. Was there any other woman on board, somebody's wife or some other crew member?
Yes. On that ship, first ship I got. Only in first ship I got. One cadet was there. Mamata Pandey, and one chief officer wife she joined later, and second engineer wife joined some month later.
Okay.
Yes.
So people were used to saying, you know, because cadet was already there. So people, I mean, was there any kind of, you know, did you find people, you know, getting angry that there's another girl come on board or she's an electrical officer? How will she work? How was chief engineer and the engine room staff with you?
Yeah, engine room staff was very good. I got one senior electrical officer. I got chance to work under him. And then he was like, he doesn't want me to do any, like, he just want me to be with him only, all electrical work. And he was very much strict there, every day taking my class, evening, like, asking me to read the drawings, and every Sunday taking my exams. You know, he will give me for the troubleshooting something. Like, in Sunday, I used to go at 9 o'clock, and he will go early in the morning, engine room. Then he will make somewhere, he know in which circuit, he will make some fault, he will put the wrong fuse or something, some wire, and then he will ask me to troubleshoot that. Likewise. And other all, like, they used to, like, if second engineer is giving me some work, or any other engineer, then electrical officers, he used to get angry. He was very much strict.
but don't you realize that, you know, that was the best training he could have given you?
Exactly, sir. I was so much lucky to have him. He gave me, he was so strict. I used to cry and I used to be so much angry at that time. But I learned a lot. He taught me a lot. That was like a training period we have to be.
Because I would say, you know, it's any person who has a senior like him, who was, you know, changing, you know, making the wrong circuits and this and that, and, you know, teaching you. I mean, that person is the best teacher you can ever have, you know. Normally, all of us, when we go to the ship, we don't get the teachers like that, you know. We have to struggle and learn. But he was strict with you, but he wanted you to learn, and, you know, he made sure you became a good electrical officer later.
Yes, yes. For first 1 month, he did not allow me to touch anything. I used to be so much angry, like, if you won't allow me to work, how will I work? He's just scolding, be with him, just observe him, whatever he is doing, you know. But after that, later on, he used to teach a lot. We will not get any electrical officer like that. If there is no work also, he will send me to read the drawings and manuals. So he made me to read, like, in a
so
habit.
He also, you know, not only practical, but he also made you learn the theory, the circuits and other things, you know.
Yes, yes.
Right.
But in other ship, I get. Yes.
Yeah. So in SCI, you just did one ship, right?
Yes, in SCI, sir.
And then you joined?
I was in SCI, Anglo? Then I... No, not Anglo, sir. Then I gave my
after
COC
SCA?
Exam. After SCI, yes, COC exam after first ship only. All other my friend, they signed off within 6 months and they rejoined because salary will increase. But I was like, I have to clear the exam. And like everybody was demotivating, what you are thinking about yourself. You have this much experience, you are so young, nobody will pass you. And passing rate is just 10%, everybody is getting this, that. But I used to tell these things to my mom. But mom used to say, you give exam. And I was like, if I will reply everything, still I will fail. They say, yes, you will fail. In MMD, it is like that only. Your age is not that much. You will not pass. But I gave and I was passed. First attempt.
And after that, why did you leave SCI?
Then I joined the volume ship management to have a like international, multinational crew exposure. And there I worked. Yes, I got to work on like electronic engine with multinational crews, Filipinos and all. And like, of course, salary also increment. All these
and,
things.
And what about SCI? They didn't call you or they didn't ask you why you're not joining?
No, I told them I'm joining volume. They were very happy. Okay, good. You have choose the good decision. They were supportive, very much supportive. They did not ask.
You did only one ship with volume?
I did three ship with the volume.
Oh, you did three ships. How much time total?
Total time, first ship was 7 months, 25 days. Second ship, also 7 months, and third ship was 5 6 months,
So
so
about 20 months. Okay.
around.
So after that, you joined a third company. Which one was that?
That is
Synergy?
Synergy Ship Manager. Yes, presently I am with the Synergy Ship Management.
Why did you leave Volum?
Why did I leave Volum? Because, sir, in Volum I was getting all new ships, right? So I was
Okay.
thinking, now I'm getting all new ship, how I will work on old ship? In SCI, I was working in the old ship. Then, and I just wanted to join gas tanker. My interest is to switch over to gas. And Volum did not have gas tankers. So I switched over to Synergy, and they had promised me they will give me the gas tanker. And luckily in Synergy, last ship was very old, 19-year-old ship I got. And day night work. How 7 months passed just like that?
I have to ask you one question. All of us, including me, all our life, we wanted to be only on the new ships. We were always scared of the old ship. We hated old ships. And you are one person on this earth who says you wanted to go on the old ships. Why?
Yes, sir, because in old ship, we are all, we every day we get new challenges, every day whenever we enter into the new job, so many three four lists, Amrin,
I
this
must
happen,
clap
if
for you. I must clap
thank you
for you.
so
I
much,
must
sir.
clap for you. You will rise very high in your life.
Thank you so
Your
much, sir.
thinking is totally different from the rest of the world. You think totally differently. You will rise very high in life.
Thank you so much, sir. It's been a lot to me. Yeah, thank you so much for appreciation.
Yeah. So
Yeah.
you got the gas tanker of your choice, old 18-year-old ship. You learned a lot, and then.
Not gas tanker, sir. Last ship was VLCC. They said they'll
Oh,
give me
okay.
this time gas tanker. So last ship
So
was
now you are
VLCC. They said
hoping
you.
for, okay, now you're
Yes.
hoping for a gas tanker, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm hoping for the gas tanker. So
So you
in last
signed off
ship.
in October, and next month
Yes.
you're joining, April?
Yeah, most probably, sir, this month end or next starting of
Okay.
next month.
So tell me, when you are working on board, you do whatever 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, and when you come back, do you have any target in your head ki I am going to stay at home for minimum this much time?
No, I don't have. If they will call
No,
me, I
no.
will go.
So
If
if they call you in 20 days, will you go?
No, sir, when I am on board, I plan for the work, whatever work I have at home. So I'll complete that, and I don't like to be idle, So when I'm on board, so I'll plan this and this things I'll have to finish this time. So those things in how much time I finish,
Wait,
I
wait,
do
wait,
judge.
wait, wait. So when you are on board, you're planning work. Once you are home, you have some work over there, you plan that work.
Yes, sir,
Oh
yes,
my
sir, am
God.
I?
What kind of work is that?
Thank you, sir. My holiday should not go in vain, right? So I have to plan
No, but tell
this.
me what kind of plan, what work, what do you plan for, chutti time?
Chutti time, sir, with the family trip and any renovation at home, or we'll have to sister marriage. So as soon as I sign off, I do plan within 20 days I'll finish this much shopping, and this date we will decide. Within a month, marriage should take place. Then after that we can be free. So likewise I planned all these things. This time we have to finish this means this. That is a small deal or a big deal. So last time marriage finishing, before that renovation of home, and meanwhile that we should have some time to family trip also. So all these we have to do some planning.
All of us, we meet so many people in life, and like I have met, at this age, I must have met, thousands and thousands of people from the marine industry, from outside. There are, just a handful, maybe 2 or 5 or 10 people who, leave some impression on you. And I don't even know you. I have met you, I'm chatting with you hardly half an hour. And you have left so much impression on my mind that I want to, be connected with you all your life, and I want to see where you go, eventually in your life. And I'm sure you'll do wonders in your life. Your thinking is totally
Thank you,
different.
sir.
You are so operational, and your mind is always active. And it's amazing. It's very rare to find people like you. On
Yeah.
top of that, you're bubbly, full of life, happy, and enjoying life. I'm sure people on board also must have enjoyed your company, right?
Yes, sir. Sure. Even in my one of my appraiser chief engineer, he wrote that it was very much like with her, like we crew enjoyed working with her, and she is so bubbly and all this. I was thinking, is it necessary to write in the appraiser? He wrote that comment. I still remember.
Yeah, because
Yeah,
you are
and.
that type. Okay, I'll ask you one more question. I read somewhere, you said that you would like, you feel very strongly about women's right and gender equality. I also, I run an NGO, and in my NGO I work for women and children, and I do a lot of workshops for the school children and college children regarding gender equality and gender bias, etc., etc. So somewhere you have mentioned that you w would want the companies to give a maternity leave, paid leave, right?
Sir, voice was broken. Please, pardon
Okay,
again.
somewhere you have mentioned that you want shipping companies to give the women paid maternity leave, right?
Yes. I had mentioned it before in my someone of my
Yeah,
interview. Yes.
and since my next connecting question is, like, you had struggled to find a ship as a lone woman, that to a ETO, and how men are, their first preference is men, and women are, I have interviewed a couple of other women also from the Merchant Navy, and they always had a struggle, with the men to find a ship, to survive on the ship, there was always a struggle. Don't you think if you at this early stage, if you start asking for that, companies are going to get scared, and maybe that will be difficult for you to find companies, or you don't care about it?
Sir, every industry has that thing, right? So shipping should also have.
I
And
mean, yeah. First of all, I must say that I 100% agree with you. I agree with you totally. But I am just thinking, my mind is thinking that what if some companies say, oh, this girl may be a trouble tomorrow, and she'll be asking these questions. So I just, this question came in my head. So I want to know your views on that.
Sir, like if they are paying, like we are connected with the, first of all, we are connected with the company. Like if we are getting leave or we are not scared about our job. And like if or else they can give us any office job in office. So rather than sitting idle, something we have something to do, So right,
Right,
as
right,
you know
okay.
my thinking, I cannot sit idle during that time also, or like I don't think about that, about family
Very
planning.
good.
But
Okay.
huh, but still, about others, like they should have something to, they are connected with the family and industry and all these things, So like, as you know, it is very much difficult for girls to get job in a ship, and every
Right,
ship is a
right.
challenge for us,
Absolutely.
still, like, huh, we are in a company, and like before joining every ship, if it is a management company, so they do send approval to the owners, for the female. Sometimes I will tell you about one of my friend. She's a second engineer, top four. And then she reached airport, all these things, joining process, everything is done. The day she is going to join the ship, and she is getting a response. Owner has rejected. Owner is not approving as you are female. Before that, they did not knew that you are a female. They were not knowing about it. How bad feeling it will be. You are at the airport and everything, and then you have to return back to the home. It's not, many of the owners, so for girls it is difficult. So I'm really sad about it. I'm really very sad to say about it. Even I have faced it once. Owner is not approving, owner is not entertaining female. Is it our mistake to born as a female?
Absolutely,
Right?
absolutely.
Yeah. Yes, we are performing well. We have proved ourselves. everything we are doing, after having lots of experience, you are telling them like because she is female, she cannot join this shift, you know. And like, of course, second engineer, so
Yeah,
much of
continue.
experience, and like to the experienced people, they do get to hear that. So we are scared. Like, I don't know how this mentality will change, industry mentality. What is the solution for this? And like, this is the. I'm not saying to like demotivate anyone, but this is the real we should. Yes, and
Absolutely. You are going to be a role model for many, many, many women, and especially women in the marine industry.
yes,
And more
because
power to
female.
you.
Thank you so much. Because the female are scared, you know, although they are performing and like they are not able to tell the truth in any interview. They are scared if they tell this, so other will not accept them. They met all
Right.
like so they are so they are not able to tell the truth, but this is the truth of the industry, you know. Although like many organizations, international bodies, they are supporting many women, women empowerment, everything is going on. So company have started taking females, they are taking, right? They have started, but on board is still like, it is for me, it is common to work. I feel as I am an electrical officer, I don't feel I am a female. You know, there is no rank as a female electrical officer.
Absolutely,
Yes.
absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, bilkul,
Yes.
bilkul.
There is a rank only as an ETO only. So we should
Yeah,
perform well.
doesn't
We should
matter
work as an
male or a
ETO, not
female.
female. Female. We should not think that we will be treated queen or something different. You know. So what I was
Right.
about to say. Yeah, connection
Don't
is
worry,
broken.
don't
Right.
worry. Continue. Continue
Yeah.
talking, continue talking. I am enjoying this talk.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. So, actually, what I was saying, I have this habit, like Gajni habit.
Okay. A little bit about, little bit
Actually, sir.
about, tell me a little bit about women's rights. We are already talking about, you know, the women's rights, etc.
Yes.
How do you feel about it? Yeah.
Yes, women rights, sir. It is very good to see now, like everybody, many many industry organizations, they're supporting female, and company also have started taking female. But still, you know, onboard culture is different. They don't have habit to see female because from starting they did not work with a female. It is bit awkward or difficult for the onboard crew to work with a female. But for us, I feel it is normal. For me, it is normal. Can't say about everyone.
Do you know second engineer Nayari 9?
Yes, I know, I know, I know, sir. With the time, it will
Okay,
change.
so I had a chat with her a few days ago, and you know, when she was a fourth engineer, she had a very, very bad chief engineer who gave her a very tough time, and she struggled over there. And people, and she was probably the first female, you know, in those times. And nobody accepted, you know, before even she came to the ship, people were already fighting, you know, why a woman, a fourth engineer coming on board? And she had a very tough time, you know. So slowly, slowly, the industry is accepting the fact, and companies are also taking.
Yes, companies are also trying, and it will change with the time. It will change with
It
the
will
time.
change.
Yes, for me also,
Right,
sir, while
right.
I went after like my COC first time as an ETO, I had really, really very tough time. Same like chief engineer in office also, superintendent, he briefed me about that. Okay, Amrin, so and so chief engineer is there. People cannot survive in front of him. So think before you join the ship. But I said, I have decided I will go there and prove myself. And on board also, he gave me very tough time. But sir, I'm so thankful to him. Because of him, I became so much strong, you know. Now, whatever problem comes, anything comes at any time, I'm ready for that, you know. So yeah, it was really, I don't want to, it will be a big story. I will share about it. Yeah, if you want. But you know,
Yeah,
he
I
want
won't,
you
I
would.
won't. I...
Okay then, sir, I will share
Yeah,
about
yeah.
it. So as I join
Even
the ship.
I'll just tell you one thing. This chat, I can save only up to 59 minutes. If it is more than one
Okay.
hour, then it cannot be. So what I'll do is, if I see that a chat is going, you know, beyond the 59 minutes, then I'll stop at 55 or something today, and then I will call you again maybe tomorrow or day after. Is it okay for you?
It's completely fine, sir.
ठीक
Completely.
है, सो यू कंटिन्यू कंटिन्यू विद योर स्टोरी, लॉन्ग स्टोरी.
Okay, sir. Then the chief, I joined that ship. You know, first time alone, independent as an ETO VLCC. Okay. Then the chief engineer, he doesn't want female directly. So he won't anyhow. I should get I should sign off. He is giving me work like that, shouting in front of everybody, unnecessary. We were in court. He was like, he want me to sign off. He was like in front of workshop, everything. He was shouting at me and giving me the work like which is pending from a year or many many days. And I was doing everything, troubleshooting calmly. Okay, I know office already has explained me about him, and I have, because as I am a first lady, there is a lots of responsibility on my shoulder, and I was continuing with that. And then one fine day, within a week, and he's like, I kept it VLCC, we had lots of workshop and all. I just joined the ship and it was in port. He's saying he's doing back to back on that ship, and he's saying I kept that thing there, why can't you find it there? It is there. I don't know. I just joined the ship. I have to familiarize myself. I have to take inventory and all these things I have to do after that only. But I can't say all this to him. That he also knows that, right? There's no point of saying that. I used to just listen to him and like going searching up and down here and there. Then we went out of port. And then one day, within a week, one day after 4:30, the ship was not in UMS. He's saying he want to put ship in UMS, and it was not in UMS due to the fire alarm system was not working in that ship, and I have to repair it. So did he remember that after 4:30 only, when whole day we are tired and we are going to knock off? Okay, no problem. I'm here for work. I will do it. And nobody told me there was lots of spare about for that fire alarm system. So okay, then I was trying, it was not working. It was not working. And everybody was scared. Nobody is telling me okay, the spare has came thrice and
Can't hear you, can't hear you. Your signal is gone.
thrice
Your
only. It
signal
will
is
not I am not
your
spoiling it. Yes. Yes, sir.
signal is gone. Couldn't hear anything. You have to tell
Oh
me
my
again.
God. Okay, I will
Yeah, I
tell you
mean,
again.
okay. You were looking for spares, et cetera, and then.
Then one day in the evening after 4:30, he came and he want ship to be put in UMS. And ship
Okay.
sir, can you hear me?
Yeah. I can hear
Sir,
you.
are you there?
I can hear you. I can hear you. Continue, continue. Continue. I can hear
Yes.
you.
Okay. My signal is bad.
Can you hear me? Okay, I'm Siska. Thank you very much. Much love to her from Tanzania. Thank you. Thank you, Sahar Godarzi. Sahar Godarzi, thank you. Sun Moon Private Limited, she's Titan of Maritime Universe. Yes, she is. Thank you. Pradeep Gowda, thank you. She Perfusionist, inspiring. Thank you. Sundar Rajan, God bless you, girl. Yes, God bless her. Thank you, everyone, for your wonderful comments. And yes, signal is lost. So I think, viewers, what I'll do is I'll terminate the chat, live chat for today, and I'll come back again maybe tomorrow or day after. And get a part two with Amreen. I'm sure she has many, many, many interesting stories to tell us. And we'll continue the chat from there. And until then, good night and goodbye. I'm signing out.